To do it. too far of the land, there's joy. And Psalms it says, weeping may endure for a night. But joy. See, when a person gives up their last breath, the Bible refers to the period of time merely as a sleep. It's time to rest from the myriad of cares, worries, and terrors. Jesus, our loving Savior, refers to the time of the death of his son Lazarus. In John chapter 11, he said unto him, our friend Lazarus, kind of sleep, what happens to your body that? And then you have to see my skin, because it will be a nature. So that I take that I was registered, I was put it to the ground, so I would get the self-pity to that thou art, and to that thou art. You put it all in that, and all you put it back in the back. You say the after then, so the doctor came to live out of the body. The spirit, which is what indicated about the life, they couldn't survive. But we died in hope. I think there's going to be that coming later. Every one of us wants to live. Nothing else to die. It was some of the most people who disaster in their life, they couldn't live. Almost every person that has attempted suicide and who survived wants to live. Because they have a self and a hope that one day they do whatever they do. Ecclesiastes says something really interesting. This is the modern reading that says, we have made everything beautiful in its time. We have also set eternity. If you do the reason you're not satisfied with temporal life, you're not happy when someone dies. Death is not natural. It is something that our Creator never intended to happen to any human in this life. Many people tell you that you'll never tell you to die, but you're not on your own. But you almost come to and then that's the whole of life. Explore and risk everything to find out how to use that function is going to give them a life of life. And we as believers in 1 Corinthians 15, verse 19 say, if in this life only we have hope and trust here along the way, let's do it gently. We long to us. We do have a hope and future. The great apostle Paul, this person said, behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed in a moment. In the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump, for the trumpets are sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible. And we shall be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. And this corruptible shall put on incorruption, and this mortal shall put on immortality. Then shall we walk through past the seven which is written, death is coming up in victory. O death, where is thy sin? O grave, where is thy victory? O sin, O death, O sin, the strength of sin is the law, but thank you to God who gave us all the victory through our Lord. And then we did. We talked about this devotion. We did not have the hope of the resurrection only. Revelation 4. 14, verse 13. And I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, thou blessed are the day of thine reward and control. Make a day to say that they rest from their labor and their work is covered on. And if you look at various things in the Bible, it can be clear that we have a living hope. A hope that is going to be resurrected higher than the temple and see him come in and resurrect him. Can you imagine? Wait. I want you to think about it, especially the time of year, as you're thinking about your mother, your grandmother. There is a place that God still wants to rest here in this place. And it's not even in this place. Neither shall there be any more time, neither shall there be any more time for the former place. A place where all things are made new. The Psalm says, I saw a new heaven and a new earth. For the first time in a new heaven, it has place in the world of the world. It's not a new place like this one. A new heaven and a new earth. Look at the sky and the apostle Paul. And as far as the sun, and of course, there is a reckoning on the right, which is the Lord of life itself. And not to the only one of all the marshals. Remember what's going to be like today? Don't forget the meaning. And the prophet Paul wrote something just perfect for those out there. He writes, but I would not have you to be ignorant brethren, concerning them, which are at peace. But you follow not, even if I were to be kind of man. For we believe that he is right, and that can even show them all to be peace and be there, for God's sake of sin. But if we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we declare, or all to be standing unto the coming of the Lord, shall not hurt on them which is ours. For the Lord himself that is sent from heaven to the south is the voice of the archangel of the temple of God and the very heart of the righteous. Then we will cry out in the name of the heart together with them in the sun to meet the Lord in the air and close the eternity. Therefore, it is long enough to be here. To me, I desire to give him We've got time for us to carefully connect and evaluate our life, to know our standing with our Creator. And in the day of salvation, have God, to thy rest, that thy peaceful thy feet, while o'er thy grave bending in sorrow weep, in love of his soul, in his life's illusion, born from our numbers to the soul, silence. Sleep through thy slumber in quiet and calm, beneath the green curtain of blossoming love, as soft as thy pillow and rosy thy bed, mournful the comfort of the day. God knows the tenderness and the ground, the truth that he follows illumines the ground. In the arms of the Savior, he comes to us, the rose that awakens, for that is not the truth. He is not for the truth that he labored and done, to be faithful to beauty, the treasure has won, the jewel was clear forever to shine, a gem in the pasture, the immortal divine. Not long will earth's wisdom have tested for the high, and that really thoughtful person will be mine, for simply approaching the secret of day, to bring the bright sun, arise, come. And we are happy. If you make the peace together, nothing to remember for life, but to despise everything.